Thank you. Treasure in heaven. We will read in the book of plataforma. Verse 36. Hallelujah. Then you will see why it is good to keep your treasure in heaven waiting, or why it is good to do good to your fellow brother or sister as a Christian. Amen? Are we there? This is the story of Tabitha, named Douglas. Amen? A wonderful servant of God, a disciple of God Almighty. Amen? And you will see the great things, you will see the benefits. That even when she was in darkness, because of the goodness that she did, God bring her back to life. Amen. We will read from verse 36. At Joppa, there was a certain disciple named Tabitha, which is translated Lucas. This woman was full of good and charitable deeds, which she did. But it happened in those days that she became sick and died. Hallelujah. I'm going to show you today. She was doing charity deeds. She was doing good and charity deeds. And she said in those days that she was sick and died. Now the story continues. Amen? When she became sick and died, when they had washed her body and laid her on the upper room, and seeing Lydia was near Joppa, and the disciples had heard that Peter the apostle was there, the servant of God Almighty, they sent two men to him, imploring him that not to delay in coming to them. Then Peter arose and went with them. When he had come, they brought him to the upper room, and all the widows stood by him, weeping, shouting, and turning, and gathering with Douglas as met while she was with them. Hallelujah. Are we together on that verse? Are you reading it? When Douglas passed away, there were widows, there were many people. Even where they left her, there were many people, widowers, and other members. They were there, crying, weeping, throwing their clothes, showing the garments, and other things that Douglas, when she was still alive, she did for them. Amen. She was doing, so my friend told me, if the Lord appear now, what will be your own faith? What will you seek and say, or what will your brother seek and say, this is the goodness that this my brother or my sister has done for me? Now, Peter put them all out and kneeled down and prayed. And turning to the body, he said, Tabitha, arose. Arise. And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. Then he gave her his hand and led her up, and when she had called the saints and the widows, he presented her alive. Hallelujah. What would be your own case? God forbid that if you die today, how will your brother or sister as a Christian will cry for you? You can see, just because of the goodness that she was doing in the society or in the community, even after she died, people were still crying. These are all the deaths that they were raised in the Bible that we do not know. We only know that Jesus raised people from the dead. But these are great things when they happen. Just for someone that was doing good to the neighbors, doing good to the widowers and the needy. Peter prayed and present. How marvelous it is that somebody died and rose again. How long will it be? Just because she was doing good in the society. right from the beginning. I ask that question. Where do we keep our treasure? The treasure is not just to bring in the house of God, it is to help your fellow brother and sister. Whatever you do to your fellow brother or sister, you do it to Jesus. Hallelujah. Remember, when Paul was going to Damascus to crucify the student of God, when he met Jesus on the road, you know that Jesus was crucified on the cross of Calvary. So Jesus was telling Paul, Apostle Paul, that you are crucifying me. So whatever you do to your fellow brother or sister, you are doing it to God Almighty. So where do we keep our treasure? When thieves are men, when rust, or are we keeping them in heavenly places? As children of God, how many brothers have you had in the beginning of this year? What have you rendered to the Lord Almighty? How many times have you bowed to the heart of God? How many times have you acknowledged God for the goodness? Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.